There is no need for magnetic pole detection when you use the Motorcoder. Sensor lab. When using Mitsubishi or Panasonic servos and incremental encoders, you may have had the inconvenience of detecting magnetic poles every time you turn on the power. In particular, magnetic pole detection is often not performed well in heavy loads or gantry-type stages. If magnetic pole detection is not performed well, noise and vibration increase, and the load increases during motor operation. The Motorcoder uses the permanent magnet of a linear motor as a scale without a separate scale. When manufacturing a linear motor system, if magnetic pole detection is performed once in a no-load state, the user no longer needs to detect magnetic poles. In summary, I will show a short video of driving a linear motor without detecting magnetic poles after turning on the power using a Mitsubishi servo. I turn off the servo drive. Communication was lost in the program and I quit the program. I turn on the servo drive and rerun the program. I run a test drive without magnetic pole detection. I move the linear motor 300,000 counts at 300 mm per second speed. In this way, even when the power is turned off and on, the linear motor can be driven immediately without magnetic pole detection. Why should you do magnetic pole detection? To briefly explain, magnetic pole detection is a function in which the servo drive detects and stores the deviation in the relative positions of the linear motor coil and linear encoder. If you don't do this, you won't be able to control the linear motor. In general, when using an incremental encoder, a magnetic pole is detected every time the servo is turned on and off. You may ask, this is usually not necessary for servo motors. Magnetic pole detection must also be performed on servo motors. However, since it is only performed once when manufacturing a servo motor, users use it without detecting magnetic poles. If you look at the Mitsubishi manual, it says that the rotary servo motor has magnetic pole detection completed at the time of manufacture, so you do not need to do it. Magnetic pole detection is necessary when you use linear servo motors. In the manual, magnetic pole detection may not be performed if you use an absolute position linear encoder. The Motorcoder senses the absolute position of the coils and magnets even without connecting the battery, so the user does not need to detect magnetic poles. In the case of linear motors, like rotary motors, if an absolute position linear encoder is used, the user does not need to detect magnetic poles. If magnetic pole detection is performed once when producing a single axis, using the linear motor coils, permanent magnets, and linear encoder, users just need to use it right away. As the manual, magnet pole detection is best down with no load. If the structure is gantry or the load is heavy or tilted to one side, such as a vertical axis, it may not be done well. When manufacturing a linear motor using the Motorcoder or an absolute position encoder, it is recommended to perform magnetic pole detection once under no load horizontal conditions, and not perform magnetic pole detection during use. The Motorcoder is a battery-type absolute position linear encoder. However, this is an electric angle absolute position linear encoder that does not need to detect magnetic poles even if the battery is not connected. I will introduce a video of performing magnetic pole detection according to the process in the Mitsubishi Linear Servo Manual. First, among the linear servo motor magnetic pole detection methods, select the default setting value, magnetic pole detection at first servo turn on, then turn the power off and then on. Second, when I run a test drive, magnet pole detection is performed first. When I press yes, magnet pole detection is started. The motor moves back and forth while making electrical noise. Magnet pole detection is complete. Third, I change the speed to 100 mm per second and drive the motor in the forward and reverse directions to check whether the magnetic pole detection is successful. I move the linear motor shortly by 65,536 counts, which is one cycle of the magnet pole pair. And I check it by moving the 300,000 counts. Fourth, I set it to no magnet pole detection so that magnet pole detection will not be performed from now on. Fifth, I clicked on the magnet pole detection information and confirmed that the lower four nibbles of the magnet pole position were 3EF3. In the encoder information comparison, you see the top four nibbles are FFFF and the bottom four nibbles are around 6E1E. Turn the power off and then on. First, if you click on the magnetic pole information, the lower four are 3F3, the same as before turning off the power. Even if you turn the power off and on, the magnet pole information is stored in the servo drive and does not change. Second, the motorcoder senses one cycle of the pole pair of the linear motor magnet with 16-bit resolution, so data 2 is the current absolute position of the coil and magnet. If you look at the encoder information, 4 nibbles in the current position are approximately 6 CCA. The current position has changed slightly as the linear motor is turned off and moves, but you can see that the lower 4 nibbles at the current position are not initialized to zero, and sensed well even though the encoder power is turned off and on. The motorcoder can sense the absolute position of 16-bit data, the lower 4 nibbles, to determine the magnetic pole position even without connecting the battery. If it was an incremental encoder when you turn it off and on, the current position is initialized to zero and the magnetic pole position cannot be determined. You cannot drive it immediately. I'll turn it off and on again and drive it right away. By the stored magnet pole information and the sensed current 16-bit absolute position, I can drive it without performing magnetic pole detection even when the power is turned off and on. Let's drive a linear motor at 300 mm per second with a moving distance of 300,000 counts. When using a motorcoder, you can confirm that you can drive a linear motor well without magnetic pole detection. In the next video, I will explain in detail what magnetic pole detection is, and why motorcoders do not need magnetic pole detection. Thank you for watching. It will be easier to watch the next video if you subscribe and turn on notifications. Sensor Lab.